crown. His dreams are choking.
Today we celebrate Children's Day, second Sunday of June of each year. It's designated as a day that we lift up our children and give God praise for them. I'll be sharing from the Gospel according to Matthew, the 19th chapter, beginning with verse 13. Join with me, Matthew chapter 19, verse 13, and I'm reading from the Contemporary English Version. Some people brought their children to Jesus so that he could place his hands on them and pray for them. His disciples told the people to stop bothering him. But Jesus said, "Let the children come to me and don't try to stop them. People who are like these children belong to God's kingdom." After Jesus had placed his hands on the children, he left. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you and praise you for your word, and thank you for this preaching moment. Let the words of our mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. Lord, you are our strength and our redeemer. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. There's lots of references in the Bible about children. Children are mentioned on a number of occasions. There are different sayings about children, and I'm mindful of one by Herbert Hoover who says, "Children are our most valuable resource." This carries many different meanings. In biblical days, children were considered a resource. Children were considered important, but the culture was very different than it is now. Children were active participants in the economic, social, political, and religious cultures. Children had specific roles and jobs and were considered property. Children added value to the household. They had specific gender tasks. In addition to that, they were also taught about God. Children bring us a lot of joy. I'm mindful that when we were worshiping in the sanctuary, when children would come in, it was just something about that brought us joy. When we would see our children walk in and have a seat in the pew, we would just smile. I could just see the smiles on the people's faces. Something about the presence of children that bring us joy. When a child would sit down and snuggle up to someone that they care about, it would just bring a smile on people's faces. No doubt, children bring us a lot of joy. They are special. Children are a gift from God, a reward from Him. Scripture tells us that children are a blessing from God. Now, we know sometimes we don't think so. Sometimes they kind of get on our nerves. But children are a blessing. God wants parents to teach their children about Him, to teach them about God's wisdom. In our text today, Jesus is moving about and teaching and sharing with the community. Can you imagine Jesus coming into town and the word gets out that Jesus is there and people are trying to go to that location to see where Jesus is? So this is what's happening. And so Jesus is there and he's teaching and all the people are gathering, they're assembling all around Jesus. And in our text today in chapter 19, Jesus is teaching about marriage and about divorce and about celibacy, and he's teaching about children. People have been gathering around Jesus, hearing his teaching, learning how to live together, and getting healed. The word was out that Jesus was in town, and he drew a crowd. Mothers heard about Jesus, and they were excited to take their children to Jesus. I'm saying mothers because mothers had the primary care of children in that time. And so they were excited about taking their children to Jesus. And the scripture tells us that the little children were brought to Jesus. They had heard about Jesus and wanted Jesus to bless their children, to touch them, and to pray for them. Now, customarily, the children would be taken to the synagogue, and the elders and the scribes would bless the children. But since Jesus was in town, they wanted to get their children to Jesus. I can just imagine the excitement of getting to Jesus, making their way through the crowd where Jesus was gathered. Obviously, they held Jesus in high esteem. They wanted to get their children there, but something quite surprising happened. As they were taking their children and pressing their way, and there were crowds, and the men, of course, were up front. And the disciples turned and saw these parents trying to get their children to Jesus and said, "Stop." They shooed them. They said, "Don't bother him." Can you imagine how the children felt? Can you imagine how those disappointed parents have
how they felt. Have you ever tried to get to Jesus and somebody got in your way? Have you ever tried to take your children to the church and somebody made you feel like that it was not important enough, or your children were not significant enough for you to even be concerned about taking them to church or taking them to Jesus? Have you ever been excited about getting to Jesus, but you just could not get close enough? Here we have this situation, this crowd, and the parents are taking their children, but yet the disciples who had been with Jesus, the disciples that knew that Jesus loved children, they said no. Now, we don't really understand why they said no. Perhaps they thought the children were insignificant. Perhaps they thought and were protecting Jesus because Jesus was a teacher. Because perhaps they just did not have the spiritual insight to know what they should have done. Maybe they thought this would be an interruption to Jesus' teaching, or maybe they thought that it just wasn't that important. We must consider that in that time, Jesus' children were not necessarily considered as enduring as we consider them, only perhaps to their parents. Many cultures see children as sweet and innocent and even wise, but the Jewish culture did not see children in the same way. The disciples may have thought it was socially improper for the children to approach Jesus. There is no reason to think that they were motivated by unkindness, but perhaps they just thought they were protecting him. Whatever they thought, they were wrong. Jesus was known for breaking cultural barriers. Jesus was known for ministering to those that were least likely assumed to be ministered to. When Jesus saw what was going on, he corrected the disciples. When Jesus saw what was going on, I could just imagine that he could not believe that they were not allowing the children to come to him. He said, "Don't turn them away. Let the children come to me." He gave them a pass. He gave them a VIP pass. He let them know that, no, don't turn the children away. Don't scold them. Don't hinder them. Don't get in their way. Don't forbid them. Let the children come to me. Don't bother them. That's what Jesus said. Can you imagine as a child with your parents? And you're trying to get through, and you're told no, but then Jesus shuts that down and says, "Oh no, move over, get out the way, let the children come in." Sometimes people will encourage children, and sometimes they will discourage. Sometimes children are considered to be those to be seen and not heard. Sometimes children are not valued as much as they should be valued in the church. Sometimes children are left up to the side. They're even marginalized in the church. Sometimes children are not perceived as being valuable to the well-being of the church. But Jesus makes it clear that he wants the children. Jesus makes it clear that he would not allow them to get in the way of the children getting to him. Jesus says, "Let them come. Let the children come to me." Scripture says that we are to train up a child in the way that he should go, and when he's old, he will not depart. I want to say in this context that training up a child in the way he should go is taking your child to Jesus. Training up a child in the way he should go is taking your child to church. Training up a child in the way he should go is teaching your child about the love of Jesus. Training up a child in the way he should go is being the example of love before your children so they will come to know him as their personal savior. Training up a child is taking your child to Jesus so then when they're old enough, they will go to Jesus. Training up a child is taking your child to be touched by Jesus, to be prayed for, so that way when they grow up, they will go to be touched by Jesus. They will go to be prayed for by Jesus. In this context, I can just imagine what it was like. They were small children. The parents were teaching by parenting them the importance of being in the presence of the Lord. Do we encourage the relationship with Jesus, or do we hinder it? Do we allow our children to decide whether or not that they will attend church? Or do we parent them and tell them they will? Do we make decisions for our children that will draw them closer to Jesus, or do we allow them to have their way? Do we allow our children to stay at home and do whatever it is they want to do, but yet we still go to church? Train them up in the way that they should go, and when they're old, they will not depart. Children are young and impressionable. What they see us do will impact what they think about Jesus. How they see us respond to them will impact what they think about Jesus. It is important that when we encounter children that we show them love. It is important that when we encounter children that we embrace them. I have to just pause for a moment and realize that perhaps somewhere down in our background, perhaps we have said something to a child that we should not have said. Perhaps we have ignored a child when a child was trying to get to Jesus. Perhaps we thought the children should not come into the sanctuary, but only be in children's church when the child was yearning to be in where everyone else is. Perhaps the children sat in the back because we didn't think it was important for them to be up close and hear everything that was going on. Perhaps we have harmed a child in some way because we did not allow them to get to Jesus. The gospel lets us know that Jesus was indignant with the disciples. Jesus was upset. Jesus was hot. Jesus was very concerned. He was displeased. He was disappointed. And it's the same thing today. Jesus is disappointed in us when we get in the way of the children. Jesus is disappointed when we hinder their spiritual well-being. Jesus is concerned about us when we don't value the children. He said, do not forbid them. Do not try to stop them. People who are like these children belong to God's kingdom. It wasn't that the kingdom of heaven belongs to them, but because of the kingdom of heaven, it belonged to those like them, like children, a childlike spirit, a childlike attitude, because a child depends on their parent. A child relies, a child has faith, a child believes. It is those that the kingdom of heaven belongs to. The kingdom of heaven belongs to all who have the childlike eagerness and faith to come to Jesus for his blessing. We need to attract children to Jesus, not drive them away. Jesus said, anyone who welcomes a little child like this on my behalf is welcoming me. The church has to be a place where children know they are important to God. The church has to be a place where children are welcome to be who they are. Not scolding children because they're not sitting still. Grown folks don't want to sit still in church. But being children and being in a loving and caring environment, if we instill the love of God in them as children, they will grow up loving God and living for him. We must take the children to Jesus so they can learn of his love. Jesus loves the little children, all of the children of the world. We must teach them that God's mercy endures forever. We must teach them that God forgives them. We must teach them that Jesus loves them unconditionally. Sometimes when children get in trouble, they think we stop loving them. And just as we nurture them, even though we have to punish them, we have to teach them that Jesus loves them unconditionally as well. That there's nothing that they can do that the Lord won't stop loving them. If we don't hinder the children and take them to Jesus, they will learn how to praise him. Last week, just in Psalms 8 and 2, we learned that out of the mouths of infants and nursing babes come praise. They will learn to praise. With the fruit of their lips, children will praise the Lord. So let us be more like Jesus. When children were taken to Jesus, Jesus laid hands on them. Jesus blessed them. He prayed for them. Jesus demonstrated the importance of us ministering to the children. He loved on them, and that's what he wants us to do. We must love the children. We must be concerned about the children. We must look out for the children. We must advocate for the children. We must let them know that we love them. And through the love we express to them, they will come to know the love of God. Tell them that Jesus loves them. Just knowing that Jesus advocated for them was a blessing. I just can imagine how they felt when they were able to step through that crowd and get to Jesus. All those trying to block them and all the people, the adults, that they can't even see Jesus, but Jesus said, clear a path for them. Let them come on to me. The children mattered to Jesus. They were important. Children are a blessing. Children are a gift from the Lord. They are a reward from Him. Let's treat them like the gift they are. Let's train them up in the way that they should go. Let's teach them that Jesus loves them. Let's teach them the importance of being in relationship with Him. Let's teach them the importance of reading the Word of God, to study, to show themselves approved workmen that needed not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Let's teach them how to pray when they and thank God when they wake up in the morning, how to pray when they go to bed at night. Let's take them to Jesus so they will know how to rely on Jesus, how to depend on Jesus, how to receive the blessings from Jesus. Let us keep on nurturing our young people. I celebrate that those children that we've nurtured down through the years have now grown up. We have some children that we remember when they were born into the church, and now they've graduated from college and have families and children of their own. We remember them because we trained them up in the way that they should go. I marvel of those youth, those young people who are on the front line, who are advocating for those who are mistreated and advocating for black lives. They've been nurtured. They've been trained up. We know that all of them out there don't know the Lord, but many of them do. They know the Lord and the pardoning of their sins. We give God praise to them. They've been trained up in the way that they should go, and they're walking in their purpose because God has a purpose and a plan for their lives, not to harm them, but to prosper them. So they've been trained up in the way that they should go, to be on the side of the marginalized, to be on the side of the oppressed, to speak for those who have been silenced, to advocate for those who need help and support. God loves the children. Let us continue to be mindful that Jesus says, let the children come to me. Don't try to stop them. Let the children come to me. Don't get in their way. Don't live your life in such a way that you get in the way of the children getting to Jesus. Don't live your life in such a way that the example that you present makes them not like the church. Don't live your life in such a way that they see you and just think that you are a hypocrite and won't love God. Don't live your life in such a way that they can't see God through you. They ought to be able to say that the Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. Let us continue to love our children, not just on Children's Day, not just on this day, but every day, nurturing them, loving them, praying for them, letting them know that Jesus loved them so much, He died on the cross. He went to the cross and knew them by name, knew what life that they would live, knew how they would serve Him, knew how He would use them. He loved them just that much that He went to the cross and He died. And on the third day, He got up with all power in His hands, and He has ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. Allow our children to get to Jesus. Allow our children to see the love of God. Allow them to see His forgiveness. Allow them to see His mercy. Allow them to see His patience. Allow them to see His long-suffering. Allow them to see that whatever trouble they get in, Jesus is able to rescue them. Allow them to understand that no matter what happens, God is able to forgive them. Allow them to know the love of God that will sustain them all of their lives. Let the children come to me, said Jesus, and do not bother them. Do not get in their way, but allow them to come. Such as these the kingdom of heaven belongs to. God bless you.